Hello, in this video we are going to discuss about the glycolysis, and in coming 7 minutes you will going to learn about the various tricks and tips about the glycolysis. Many students are find it difficult to recognize and remember the various intermediates of the glycolysis. Glycolysis is nothing but the fate of the glucose to the pyruvate. In this video, I will give you a simple trick to recognize and remember all the intermediates of the glycolysis. Then let's start. Glycolysis is a word which is made up of the two different words. It is actually a combination of two words. First one is a glyco, that means the sugar, it is a glucose, and another is a lysis, that means the breakdown. So glycolysis is the oxidative breakdown of a glucose to pyruvate. It is called aerobic glycolysis. And when same breakdown of glucose carried out under the anaerobic condition, then glucose converts to lactate. The oxidative breakdown of a glucose to pyruvate consists of 10 different enzyme catalyzed reactions. To remember these all intermediates starting from glucose to pyruvate, we have our trick. Those students have difficulty to recognize and remember the glycolysis intermediates, here is a trick for them. You have to remember this sentence. Goli ne gol phule hue phal ke dada ji ko garma garam teen do karke plate mein parose. You can find out here, there is a some starting words of the letters of the words are red, blue and green. What it indicates? The red color indicates energy investment phase, blue color indicates splitting phase, whereas green color indicates energy generation phase. As I told you, there are 10 different enzyme catalyzed reaction under glycolysis. So the four reactions 1, 2, 3 and 4, these four reactions are energy investment phase, and likewise for the blue and green color. Let's see what actually meaning of these letters. The G of the goli indicates for the glucose. Another G for the goal indicates glucose 6-phosphate. The F indicates the fructose 6-phosphate. Another F from the Fulci indicates fructose 6-bisphosphate. D for dihydroxyacetone phosphate. G for glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. From this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, the reaction proceeds further. Another G is for 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Remember that this is the second G, and hence we have to go for the bis. 3 is for 3-phosphoglycerate, 2 is for 2-phosphoglycerate, P is for phosphoenol pyruvate, and last P is for pyruvate. In this way, by knowing goli ne gol phule hue phulke dada ji ko garma garam teen do karke plate mein parose, you can able to recognize all the intermediates starting from glucose up to the pyruvate under the glycolysis. Here I am presenting with you a simple illustration of all the reactions of the glycolysis. Remember, red color is for energy investment phase, blue color for splitting phase, and energy generation phase is in green color. The very first reaction in the glycolysis is glucose to glucose 6-phosphate carried out by hexokinase, and this reaction is irreversible. Step 2, glucose 6-phosphate to fructose 6-phosphate carried out by phosphohexose isomerase. Then fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate carried out by phosphofructokinase, which is again irreversible reaction. Fourth stage, then converts to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. The enzyme is aldolase. Then dihydroxyacetone phosphate converts into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and likewise from the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, it converts to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, then 3-phosphoglycerate, then 2-phosphoglycerate, and last one to phosphoenol pyruvate to pyruvate, which is carried out by pyruvate kinase, and again it is irreversible. So out of the 10 steps which are in the glycolysis, 3 steps are irreversible. Step number 1, step number 2 and step number 3. These are the rate limiting steps, and carried out by hexokinase, phosphofructokinase. If you go specifically, it is carried out by phosphofructokinase 1 and the pyruvate kinase enzyme. In this way, it is very much easy to remember the glycolysis. Glycolysis carried out aerobically and anaerobically. In the presence of oxygen and mitochondria, the glucose is converts into pyruvate. And this pyruvate then transported into mitochondrial matrix, where it carried out oxidative decarboxylation and converts to acetyl-CoA. Further, this acetyl-CoA takes parts into TCA cycle, where complete breakdown of the glucose into carbon dioxide takes place. All we know that glucose converts into pyruvate if there is presence of oxygen. But what happens if there is an absence of the oxygen? That condition is known as anaerobic. In anaerobic condition, glucose converts to pyruvate and pyruvate is again converts into lactate. This happens inside the RBC, as RBC didn't contain the mitochondria. RBC is totally dependent on the ATP molecule generated by anaerobic glycolysis. Also, the muscles or the cells which are deprived of the oxygen or who cannot get the sufficient oxygen, they also convert the glucose to the lactate. No doubt, lactate is transported through the blood inside the liver, where it converts into the glucose through a Pori cycle. In this way, glycolysis takes place inside the cytosol. There are 10 different reactions. The figure indicates here the 10 different reactions of the glycolysis. Glucose converts into pyruvate aerobically, whereas glucose converts to lactate anaerobically. The circular reversing arrow indicates that these reactions are irreversible. First reaction, third reaction, and the last reaction, where they require the different enzymes to carry out the reversible reactions. If you like this video, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Till then, happy learning. Thank you. Bye-bye.